Welcome back to the class. We'll see the construction equipments in detail. In case of huge construction projects, definitely we are in need of equipments. These equipments should be appropriately used to have a safer, economical and timely completion of projects. Around 15 to 30% of the project cost is involved in the equipment and machineries. So in the last class I have classified what are all the construction equipments available. We'll see each and every equipment in detail. First, I would like to discuss about the earth moving equipments. And before that, what are the operations involved in a project and why we need equipments. Before starting the project, we'll be going for site clearance marking. And after marking, you need larger equipments for excavating, digging and moving the debris from one place to another place, for placing, compacting and leveling the filling materials, dosing, grading and hauling is transporting. For all these operations, we are in need of construction equipments. First, we'll go in detail about the excavating and the earth moving equipment. These are some of the excavating equipments: powershovel, backhoe, dragline, clamshell, scrappers and bulldozers. Powershovel is used to excavate the earth and to load the truck. Its excavating capacity is varies between the size from 0.375 meter cube to 5 meter cube. It can be used for harder rock. The parts of the powershovel is given. Here it is shown that this is the old powershovel and this is the newer one. You can see that the harder strata can be excavated from the place. Okay, where is it applied? It is applied for the harder material and for the big size of boulders. It is used for digging and also removing that dug material, dig out material. What are the factors affecting the output of the powershovel? It depends upon the class of material, depth of cutting and the job conditions, how much amount of transportation is needed, and it also relates with respect to the skill of the operator. Then coming to the backhoe. Backhoe is used for excavating the natural surfaces, to excavate the trench and the pits. So this is the backhoe. In that backhoe, the bucket is attached. From that bucket, it is easy to excavate the materials. Where is it applied? It can be used for trenches, basement, etc. And mainly it is used for trimming the surface. And next, coming to the drag line. As the name applies, dragging is what it is pulling. See, in this drag line, it has a longer boom. Boom is like our hand. From that boom, your hoist rope is there and a drag rope is there. With the help of these drag rope and hoist rope, the bucket can be moved here and there so that it can be, all the materials can be dragged. This is used for the softer materials and it can be deposited at some places. So it is used in canals. And coming to the clamshell. Clamshell resembles like a shellfish. As like when we want to carry some material, we'll join our both our hands together and take out the sand or water or whatever the loose materials we need. So these are the two hands. It will join the two hands and carry away the material, whatever it wants to lift. So this is called as the clamshell. It is like a bucket. Okay, bucket. It has, it can hoist and it can travel to some distance and it is able to drop that material at a particular location. We can use this for loose materials and we can use it for cofferdams, well foundations, etc. So this is the comparison chart between the different types of equipments what we have seen for earth moving. Powershovel, backhoe, dragline and clamshell. Whether this is suitable for harder soil or rock soil or rock. whether wet soil can be handled or only dry one. What about the digging? What about its loading efficiency? And how about the footing? And the digging level is below the footing level or above the footing level? And how long it can travel? Travel time. Based on these, a comparison is made. With this comparison, you can find out which equipment is best suited for your site. Thank you.